nice thing about this motorcycle is you can literally jump over speed bumps, speed breakers. Not too fast, of course. Lest somebody get the impression that I'm being rash. It's my endeavor to be anything but rash. Chewing the cud, chilling out. Well, it's a nice day to be doing that. Cloudy weather.
There's something warming about holding a good cup of coffee. I like the roast. So there's a certain sweetness to that acidity of the coffee. I like the color of the coffee as well. Just right, not too milky. It has enough strength that allows for the coffee to shine through.
Hi folks, welcome to another vlog on the channel. I'm out for another city ride on my Himalayan. It's a nice and cloudy day here. So although it's 11, it's still quite pleasant. So basically today I'm going to check out a couple of places. So I received these Instagram comments many a times asking for us to look up places. So there's this comment about this place called Mantralaya Tiffin Room. So I'm told it was a food cart, then it, because of the current situation, they had a lot of trouble. They've got to a new location. So somebody has asked us to take a look at it. So I'm going to just ride by, take a look at the place, get a sense of the place for myself. So that's where we are headed first. Do you see that guy just came in from the extreme left to the extreme right suddenly? That's what happens on the roads when you're riding or driving. You got to constantly be looking out. You got to constantly be on your guard, watching what's happening. So you have to be in a state of super alertness, whether you're on the highway or you're in the city. The nice thing about this motorcycle is you can literally jump over speed bumps, speed breakers. Not too fast, of course. Lest somebody get the impression that I'm being rash. It's my endeavor to be anything but rash. Chewing the cud, chilling out. Well, it's a nice day to be doing that. Cloudy weather. The motorcycle is feeling a bit bouncy. Air pressure correct, hai na? As opposed to earlier, it was feeling a bit cushiony. Oh, I should have gone that direction. I didn't see. Oh god, I've come on the wrong side. So can I get back there? I should have been down there somewhere. I've come up now, so I don't know how to get back down. I think I'll have to loop up. I'll have to go all the way up. No worries, I get a slightly longer ride out. Oh, that's a husky. That's the husky Swartpillen. Looks lovely, looks interesting. Basically a KTM in its soul, but re-engineered to make for the Swartpillen, the husky, the Husqvarna. Let us see what this place is about. Is this where we are? It says I'm at the post office, but I can't see this place anywhere. Oh, that's the one. I think I just spotted it. Mantralaya Tiffin Room. There's a lot happening there. There's some charts, some coffee as well. I think that's Kotha's coffee, Matha's coffee. So there's a lot happening in this store. 99 variety charts, Matha's coffee, and a bunch of other things as well. South Indian breakfast and meals, tea, coffee, Chinese charts. Not sure of this place, not sure. So typically when I get these suggestions, I kind of try and see if we can get some research done on it. And once in a while I ride out, take a look at the place if I can. And then assess some more, get some more research going. Right now I'm not very sure of this place because there's too much happening. I'm sure it must be good, but there aren't too many customers here. And that's something that I always go by. I always go by customers. I always go by what customers have to say. Because that to me is the most important aspect of evaluating a place. It's what people who frequent the places, customers, have to tell about it. So at the end of the day, customers who've been eating at a place day in, day out, usually are quite correct in their assessment of the place. I think we will park this on the back burner for now. I think next I'm headed to another place, and this is a coffee place. This is a coffee place, a cafe, and I've heard a few interesting things about it. I just want to go there and just check it out. Maybe have a cup of coffee there. So the temples around here, people visiting the temples. Oops. Am I in the right place? Does it go somewhere? You know, this place isn't too far away from where I live. But even within that, there are these nooks that you've never been to. That place there, that place at the back, reminded me of a little village somewhere. But yet it was in the heart of Bengaluru in HSR, which is where we are. Place should be somewhere on the right, further up. There we are, Third Wave Coffee Roasters. So I've heard about this place. Apparently they do some good coffee. Let's take a look. What's a good coffee?
I would recommend you the flavored latte.
Don't give me a flavored latte. Give me a coffee where I can taste your coffee. You know, flavored.
Cappuccino is normal.
So give me
latte, flat white.
So give me a, which is stronger, cappuccino or latte?
Flat
white. Flat white. What coffee do you use?
We use Arabica.
Arabica. So it's your own blend. So give me one banana walnut tea cake. Give me one flat white. So that's a strong coffee, right?
Yeah.
How old is this place?
Almost 2 years.
2 years. How old is Third Wave?
We opened the first outlet in 2016.
2016. I like the woody aesthetics of the place. There's a certain warmth to it, which is what you look to in a coffee house. So when you get into a coffee house, you want a sense of warmth. You want that ambiance to basically help you unwind and relax. And that's the sense out here. There's the aroma of coffee in the air, of course, with some baked goodies too. It's quite inviting to all your senses. You take in the sight of the place, you nose the coffee and some of those bakes. And hopefully very soon, we will also involve the sense of taste. So speaking for the last place that I went to check out. So we get many requests asking us to evaluate, look at places that are going through tough times. And we do want to try and help as many people as possible. But it's obvious that we can't really help everyone because there's only that much bandwidth that you have and there's only 2 episodes that we release in a week. Of course, we try and do things through our Instagram, through our Facebook, etc. But what's very important for us is what customers think of the place. And so a lot of the selection that we do, so although we want to help people, but for us the food has to really rule. The food has to rule the hearts of customers who frequent that place. And that's what we look for in our research. So that's the starting point. The second aspect is when I take a look, if possible, at the place. You get a sense of the place when you visit it. You get a sense of how packed it is with customers. You get a sense of what they're trying to do. So I typically try and look for places that focus on a few things as opposed to doing many things. Because I think if you focus on a few things, you'll be able to do it well. Banana walnut, the flat white. So this is an 100% Arabica. So this is from where? Chikmagalur, Coorg?
Chikmagalur.
So you have your own coffee estates or
no,
you?
We borrow from farmers.
So you procure from farmers and then you?
Then we will roast. We have separate roastery team. So they will do the roasting.
So what do? Do you do a deep roast or do you do a light roast? A medium roast?
We do a natural roast.
A natural roast?
Yeah.
So what's a natural roast?
Natural, like it's unwashed.
Huh?
Unwashed.
Unwashed?
Yeah.
So what do you mean?
We do have natural, we do have washed, natural and we do have
So are these pulp sun-dried coffees?
Yes.
The pulp PSDs?
Yes.
Okay.
We do have different flavors also.
Okay.
If you have a
little
piece.
Alright, thanks. Oh, that's interesting. So I learned that these are pulp sun-dried coffees. At least that's the impression that I get. So he says these are natural roasts. So when you do pulp sun-dried, you don't basically remove the parchment. A few things that I learned from visits to coffee estates over the years. Let's go for the coffee. Let's get rid of this mask. This is good, they serve it with demerara, which is always nice. So there's the white sugar and also the demerara sugar. I think the demerara sugar brings a little nuttiness, or brings a certain earthiness to the sweetness, if you know what I mean. Something warming about holding a good cup of coffee. I like the roast. So there's a certain sweetness to that acidity of the coffee. I like the color of the coffee as well. Just right, not too milky. There's enough strength that allows for the coffee to shine through. And what I also like is that the cup. You don't want to pour hot coffee into a cup that's cold, because then that's going to cool the coffee down really quickly. But here the coffee is hot, the cup is hot too. So as I was talking about the place that we just visited, so we try and do our research before we evaluate if a place is fit for an episode of Gourmet on the Road. We want to help people, but it's important that for us to do an episode has enough merit for us to help spread the word on it, because that's very important. So today with Gourmet on the Road, we reach out to millions of viewers in the city, in the country, and even beyond. So when we speak for that experience, when we speak for that eatery, we have to be dead sure that this is a place that people will like. Of course, everybody has their own taste, so what may appeal to you may not appeal to me, what may appeal to me may not appeal to a third person. But that's a different thing. But we want that the food has to appeal to the consumers that the eatery caters to. And that's important. Good coffee. So what's the flat white price, right? It's at 180 rupees for this big cup of coffee. And then we have the banana walnut tea cake. The tea cake is fine. I think it's also got some chocolate in there somewhere. You of course have the walnuts and you have the flavor of banana. But I think a lot of these places, they tend to reheat the bakes in a microwave. So it dries the outer layer of the cake. That's what happens. But then you have the wetness of the coffee to help with that. Today I've broken my intermittent fasting a little earlier than what I typically do. So usually I break my fast around lunchtime, 1, 1:32, depending on what time lunch is, sometimes even 3 or 4. But today, we've obviously broken it a little earlier. I quite like the aesthetics of this place. There's a certain warmth to it, a certain grown-upness to it. I think it's the sort of place you can just come and catch up with friends, catch up on work perhaps, or just relax, chill. And at least from the limited conversation that I had with the chap serving us, you get a sense that they take their coffee very seriously. In the flat white, how much coffee do you add? 40 ml. And milk?
Milk
180. 180. And in a cappuccino?
Cappuccino 150 ml, 40
ml. So the coffee that I'm drinking, the flat white, I just learned from the barista who's making the coffee, has 40 ml of coffee, Arabica coffee. I guess the espresso that is extracted out of Arabica beans. And 180 ml of milk. A cappuccino has 40 ml of coffee and 150 ml of milk. So I guess if you want something stronger, go for the cappuccino. I think the flat white actually worked out well for me, although I did ask for a strong coffee. Because I've just had some coffee at home in the morning. And too much coffee tends to give me a bit of a buzz. And if I have coffee a little later in the evening, it becomes very difficult for me to sleep. That caffeine buzz. So this flat white, although not as strong as I had originally asked for, turned out to be the right choice. So that's the thing with life. No matter what, I think everything eventually turns out to be right.
Subscriber to your channel.
Are you okay?
And I don't miss.
Okay.
And I keep forwarding them.
Nice.
Even to my relatives and friends in US, because they visit sometimes here and they should know what is available in Bangalore and surroundings. Wonderful channel.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
And very interesting. All the very best.
Thank you. So all in all, I think a nice coffee shop. Good to come here and chill over some coffee, catch up on some work, meet people. The food, well, the banana walnut cake was all right. Perhaps I should explore what they have a little more sometime when I have more time at hand. But for now, I think it's time to get back. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Well, that was an interesting coffee morning here at Third Wave Coffee Roasters. I think it's nice to see homegrown coffee shops like this come up. I think that's what we need more of.
We need homegrown coffee shops that can take the coffee that we do in Karnataka throughout the state, through the country, and also overseas. So good job, Third Wave Coffee Roasters, with the coffee. I'll perhaps explore you a little more in detail some point in the future. So that's it for this vlog, folks. Hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't subscribed to this channel already, do subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.